Welcome back, and here it is, the 1/16th scale 1950 Chevy Bel Air Convertible by AMT. It's a big kit. You saw me build up the 55 as a beautiful metallic green. I don't know what I'm going to do with this one yet, but we're going to dive into the box. It's a slightly modified 2-in-1, meaning you can build it completely stock, which is the way I like it, or you can add different wheels and a little bit of accoutrement. You can see it's got the nice V8 engine in this one, and it can be completely wired and plumbed. So let's open up the box, take a look at everything that's going to be inside. First, without any hesitation, we will get out the monstrous chassis. Check that thing out. Huge amount of detail underneath on there. Nothing wrong with that at all. I like that big slab. These are like 1/25th scale cars that just got hit by a gigantic ray to enlarge them. We've got a big interior tub. We've got our nice back seat molded in with the package shelf there. And then we've got our center hump. We've got our pedals molded in and our little rub mat there with carpet interior. And we've got the big, big Bel Air under hood. You can see the radiator mount is all molded in on this one. Firewall detail, very light, it's in there. You can hear it, probably hard to show up on the white plastic. Wipers are molded in, visors are molded in. We've got opening doors on this one. It is a sealed trunk. Nice style on that. I'm not noticing any flash or warpage or anything to worry about. We've got the doors. What else we got here? We'll throw these out. We've got the optional white walls you can put on the tires. You want some wide whites on your Bel Air. Look at that bench front seat. Nicely detailed. Smooth. Textured. Nice definitive lines in there. Shouldn't be too hard to paint by hand or spray. We've got a beautiful dashboard. Gauges molded in. We'll see if they're on the decal sheet coming up. I don't really look at these a lot before I show them off. I like to be just as surprised as you. We've got battery, what could be a heater motor, a blower motor. We've got horns, big steering wheel on there, big old intake and oil filler, and that nice hood. We'll look at it underneath. Look at it from the top. You can toboggan right on down the hill on that thing. We've got, oh, I love the sound of new styrene falling. We've got the nice doors here and the interiors with their hinges, the interior doors. Nice texture, nice straight, strong molding. The doors all have locators for the interior panels. I learned that on the 55. Let's throw out a bunch of stuff here because it's so big, it's just kind of falling around me. All right, we've got our other intake, fan, air cleaner, engine and transmission halves. Compare that to the size of a 1/25th scale. Distributor with, don't cut any of those plugs off there, starter, ignition coil, belt and pulley system, water pump, oil filler, oil pan with oil filter, starter heads, valve covers, all nice looking. We've got our seat back here. Some sort of mounts, I'm not sure what those are. Look like they're part of the interior based on the texture. We got our bonnet for the convertible top. We've got the big X member for underneath the frame. We've got our exhaust, dual exhaust and manifolds. Nice detail on the mufflers there. We've got our differential. We've got our front kingpin mounts, differential with springs, front suspension, shock system, nice big drive shaft the size of a pencil. We've got steelies, wheel backs, stock steering wheel, license plate frames. Let's go to the other side of the desk and see what's over here. We've got two metal axles, nice big thick chrome steel axles. We've got three lengths of extremely flexible rubber hose. This is your water lines. These are your plug lines And that's super, super flexible. Looks like no memory line. That's going to look wonderful. In fact, I just did that Schwinn bicycle. I'd like to know where they source this, because this would look really nice on those. I'd like to know where they can get it, period. So if you know, link it. It's hollow, extremely wet noodle tubing, and I could use that to plumb lines on other models and everything. That's outstanding. Excellent decal sheet. A lot of white scroll work in here, all kinds of emblems. I don't know what these are. They're large stripes. I don't know if those are for the seats. We got gauges and emblems for the radio. We got four license plate options. We got some flameage going on down there. And like I said, all that scroll work underneath there. We've got eight hollow vinyl tires. We've got Goodyear Rally GTs for the more modern wide meets on there. Tim Allen-esque approach with the wider tires. And we've got some nice Firestone bias plies, vintage style, black walls. And of course, you can apply those white wall emblem or those white wall pieces of plastic to it. We're going to have some chromey chrome. We've got the clear parts here, the windshield, the headlights, the side glass for the windshield frame, and we've got our red taillights. Glad those are molded in color. We've got optional valve covers and wheel package, really handsome wheel package on this one. The Thunderbird in the 55 also had optional wheels in those. You saw me do the unboxing of the 16 scale Thunderbird and the build of the 55. We've got the interior trim on the steering wheel. We've got door handles, be careful. Rear bumper, Chevy emblems on this. Check out how nice those are molded. We got the headlight buckets, hubcaps, grill, taillight assemblies on the back wings there. Another Chevy emblem. The chrome for the bottom of the hood. We got that nice emblem there for the center of the grill. You'll be able to get in there and detail that. Excellent chrome work on there. That is all the parts, so it's a big kit, but it's not overly complicated. I'm going to start working on mine and be right back. Clearly you saw the title card of the video, so you know where I'm going with this, but we'll show you. Now, one thing I want to get across to all of you out there in model world is don't shy away from the big scale kits from AMT. The 1/16th scales are nothing to be worried about. They're just larger, so you just have to use more paint, but it is actually easier to assemble these because they are so big. It's easier to detail them. It's going to be easier to wire the motor, easier to put the coil on, easier to put the radiator hoses on because it is so much larger, and it will be easier to detail the interior as well because of the size. The parts count is just what it would be in a 1/25th, pretty much. It's just that all everything is bigger. It's like the Duplo of plastic scale models. So don't be afraid of them. Get them on order, pick them up, because it's if you can build a 1/25th glue kit, you can do one of these. You're just going to have a foot of space on the shelf for one kit instead of two with 1/25th. So anyways, with that being said, let's get to the sub-assemblies. We've got the generator, the fan, and the pulley assembly. Well, that's all black. So is the air cleaner, so we're leaving that on one tree glued together. The steering wheel without its trim ring inside. I'm using the stock steering wheel on this one. We are all set to go with that. The exhaust and the manifolds, they locate with large pins. We have large clamps on the exhaust. I can paint all of this separate on a tree, weather it, detail it, and get that on there. We got the stock steelies. I'm so glad they're just not a blank wheel and they demand you use the hubcaps. You can use just steelies. So those are glued together. Those tires are hollow, soft vinyl. They will press right over the top. We're not going to have any issues with that. Those are ready to go. The cross member on the frame, we'll want to paint that separately. The chrome, I cut the chrome tree in two pieces just to make it easier to manage and get into the paint booth. As you see, I put Silly Putty inside the headlights. No matter how much rust you get on a vehicle, unless the headlights are missing, behind the glass will always be chrome. So we left that Silly Putty just squished in there. That will mask it off perfectly. The horn, the battery, the heater motor, the inner door hinges, doesn't matter. We're never going to see those. So those are all in place. We got our master cylinder on there. One tree, we can spray that all. The differential, the drive shaft, and the shocks. We can paint that separately, get that ready to go as well. You can see how nicely that differential assembles. Now we know these are quick builds, quick reviews, quick fun. I don't worry about seam lines and mold lines and stuff like that. We glue them together. If they're gigantic or get in the way, of course I'll work on them, but otherwise I just leave them. That's the way I like to model. Got the hood on its own tree so we can get that painted. Got our dashboard. We'll be able to get that painted, detailed, use the decals on it. See the size of that? That's going to be so much easier to detail than a 1/25 scale dashboard. You're going to be able to see it a lot better too. The interior tub needs no work at all before we paint it, so that's ready to go as is. The front seat glued together, ready to paint up, get some color on it. We got our armrests for the back of the car and our top. Those are ready to paint, cut off on their own tree. When I cut stuff off of a tree, like a chrome part or a painted part, when I snip it off to attach it, on a chrome part, I'll use a Molotow pen or a silver marker to touch up the area where I cut it off if it's exposed. On a painted part, I just spray a little bit of the paint in a can and dab a small brush on there, and that's good enough to hide that cutoff mark. We've got the engine inside the frame. You can see that beautiful, I'm pretty sure that's a 283. Now, some of the bumps here where we'll be attaching our spark plug wires were busted off of mine, you can see. So I'll end up having to just drill with a little wire, just drill a hole, glue a little wire in it, and then slide your spark plug wire on that after you're all painted. You'll be fine. You can do it before you paint, whenever you want. I attach everything, because we will be wiring this one up, I attach everything to it so that it is glued firmly in place with model glue. It's welded together, and then I can work on it much easier. But you can see nice detail on there. We got starter, oil filter, oil filler, water pump housing. That's a big motor with lots of nice detail, and I didn't put the valve covers on because I'm not going to use the stock valve covers. I want to use the billet aluminum ones. Got our front suspension attached with our kingpins. When you do that, what you want to do to make sure they're lined up. Now, if you want to glue those kingpins in and then attach your wheels with just a piece of this metal pin so you can have turned wheels, do so. Otherwise, if you want them straight, all you got to do is slide that metal axle in while you're gluing it together, and then you'll be assured of a straight assembly when you're all done. So make sure you don't lose those metal axles. They do help support the weight of the model. That is all we had to do. Of course, back here, there is nothing because we're going to be attaching the shocks and the differential, the drive shaft, and all that at a later point. So you just put that front suspension on, paint it up. The body itself, I have attached the doors without their hinges, just so you can see how nicely they fit. You saw that was just hanging off. You can see how nicely it pops up in there. The doors come off like so. They slide in through their hinge marks. Before you put the interior in and glue it all together, you can glue your hinges right where those little dimples are. You'll be all set to go. I've got this door taped in. Kind of know what I'm going to be doing here already, revealing a lot, but I've got one door taped on. I've got one door completely off. So that is it for the body, except for cutting those braces off, cleaning up a little back there, and attaching the top of the radiator to mine. I will be hand painting the radiator on mine, so it's my choice to do it that way. So we are all set for paint. This is going to take a good amount of paint, but I use Rust-Oleum's anyways. They're pretty cheap. So I will meet you over in the paint area. Thank you. That was a whole lot of stuff that I haven't shown before. Some of it I have, some of it I added in, and of course I'm experimenting all the time with my model making because I want to see what works for me, and I have ideas. I've always wanted to do a car that was so beat up that it was all covered in fabric and all trash so far, and that's what I did with this one. I like the way the back fabric turned out. Now, the convertible top is going to be all the way over the top of this, so we're not going to see all this extra sitting back here. That's why I didn't bother cleaning any of that up. We'll just see the folds, the highlighted folds with the paint. The front seat with the pattern didn't turn out as nice, but I did dirty it up like it gets used more, and I put two new-ish hubcaps on there to go with the ones that are already on the car and the ones that he's missing. He found these at a swap meet the other weekend when he had the car out for a beat, so that's cool. Now you can see I've placed the body over the chassis. It just falls right over the top of it, so we can see where we're going with this. I do have a little bit of work left to it. I'm going to take my rust colors once the entire car is all together. These are my favorite rust colors, and do a little spot rusting at the bottom of the sills, at the bottom of the glass, along some of the trim, but I'm not going to rot the whole thing out. I don't want to completely destroy it. Check out that awesome front bumper emblem. I've just got to add some dust to the whole model when we're done with that tile grout to dust it in. Look at that dashboard. I didn't want to attach anything. I've got the gauges in there, and I just rubbed, because these are so large, I rubbed a little bit of future floor polish on them to give them a little bit of a glass effect, but that looks lovely. Underneath there, that's going to look great. We got the battery done. We got the blower motor done. We got the master cylinder. Those are ready to go in. We got the door handles, which will be one of the very last things to attach. We got the air cleaner, which will be placed over the top. The engine is all wired, like I showed you, by putting those wires in there. That rubber tubing, of course, will make them arc over the top. It's not extremely realistic, but that's fine. I've got to dirty up the engine once it's installed, oil it up a little bit, make it a little greasy, and then I will puff a little dust on those wires to bring them down. I've got the lower radiator hose attached. I will attach that. I will cut it off and glue it on. Then I will make the rest of the upper radiator hose from the top once it's in the car and attach it like such. The steering wheel is all done and ready to go with that nice trim ring and a little bit of fade around the steering wheel. The rear bumper is rusted up a little more, where more dirt and salt will swirl in the back. We'll pull the body off. Comes off. You can see we got the two different doors. We got the interior door panels. See how much cleaner the door panels look now that we have the car done and dusted up and a little faded on the inside. I've got, might not show up, but I've got a buff colored paint rubbed into that paint on the inside. We've got the hood looking sweet. It's a replacement hood. Pulled it off another car. A little bit of rust. Not as bad as the rest of the main car here. We can see under hood how that looks. Painted that all black by hand. Showed that in the El Camino video, so I didn't need to show it on this one. Got the headlights and everything glued in place. Got the windshield and the side glass. See how cool it is when you open the door now? You're going to see the blue on the inside, but the green jams, it just all looks really cool and lines up. I got an idea for the passenger door. The underbody of this one's got some mileage on it, got some strong rust with the exhaust running back. You could cut the exhaust, you could mess with it all you wanted, but we got a nice even patina on the bottom. We got the wheels and tires dusted up with that tile grout. We got mismatch, all kinds of fun on there. All good time. So I'm having a blast with it. It's just like working on a 1/25th scale, but I get a chance to do even more. I'm going to seal up the whole kit. I've got to put the interior up inside. It'll line up. Before I do that, though, this car is completely different in that your dashboard goes in first and glues in. You can see the groove on the back of the dashboard where my pinky's touching. Lines up with the groove in the windshield. We'll put that all together. I don't bother painting the underside of this body because most of it's going to be hidden underneath there. So I didn't bother. When you turn the car over, you're not going to see anything worth looking at. So we got it all set up. All I've got to do is the final assemblies, and we'll be back with that final. Here it is, my completely different take on a 1/16th scale kit from AMT. Now, I showed you the 1/16 Thunderbird. I built the 1/16 55 Chevy convertible, and I did that one as a super shiny mint green car. I'll link to that video at the end of this video, so you can check out that build and that unboxing. But for this one, I said, rust it and crust it. That's it. I wanted to try my blanket over the seats thing. In a convertible, the seats are gonna crack and the vinyl is so hot. And you bought your jalopy, you grabbed some of mom's old Indian blankets and you threw them in the car, and that's how they look. And I think it's not the best job with those seats, but it actually looks kind of good. You know, I like that it drapes over the back naturally. We get the natural color of the seat showing through on the back, and that the dipping it in the white glue that I diluted holds it in shape. And if it was just regular fabric, it wouldn't drape and fit into the cracks and creases and crevices and drape like that and hold its folds and things. It would just be too stiff, as regular fabric is much out of scale. But when you do this and then you dry brush it a little bit to give it some detail, looks good. Took little tiny strips of real duct tape that I cut with my knife to hold the original door shut. His girlfriend's got to get in from the driver's side anyways. He found a better hood, he found a better door for the driver's side, and they're still 57 Bel Airs, so I had to dress them up as the same and just fade it less. And you can see that the inside of the door jamb is rusted and dirty, but this one didn't have any rust on it. He found it sitting in a barn, and that hood wasn't carroted, but you can see where everything else on the original has got a good amount of rust and crust on it. So I left the front emblem super clean. I figure he's always polishing that up, and I kind of wanted to make it stand out. I had even considered using the spare parts in the kit, the performance parts, like the nice mag wheels, the air cleaner, the carburetor, with these awesome Goodyear GTs, and put them on the back or something, but this one I just decided to leave it hardly touched. In fact, aside from the dash decals, I didn't even use the decals. You can save those for something else. Even though they're 16th scale, they'll fit on a lot of other stuff. So it looks wonderful. I always like to use my craft paints, and you saw how I sprayed to fade. It's kind of a cool term, sprayed to fade. The paint job, dirty everything up and have a good time with it. There'll be pictures of under the hood so you can see. I used tile grout to dust up the floors and dust up the entire overall look, so it's been driven down a few dirt roads and all that. The loosely modified door does fit. You can see it closes just fine. The passenger door opens and closes fine, but because I wanted to duct tape it shut, I painted it on the vehicle, which means the door jams inside are still white plastic. But if you didn't want to do that, just paint it up like I did with the doors off the car and remove the duct tape, and we can open that door and see. But I rusted out around that door a lot stronger, rusted out around the convertible top, dusted up that tonneau cover there for the top, and we got our bumpers on, you know. So it is a lot of fun to build this kit. Anyone, if you can build a glue kit, period, you can build the big scalers. The doors don't give you any trouble. They work really slick. Those hinge mounts for them, mine are of course loose because I've been beating it up quite a bit, but those hinge mounts work really nice underneath. The dashboard is beautiful. That engine builds up so easy. Don't forget, if you have a hard time getting those vinyl cables to stick, just use that copper wire trick I showed you in the video, and everything will go together beautifully. A little bit of super glue and you'll be all done. So thanks for watching another cool video. Thanks to Round 2 for sending this. I will link down in the description where you can get this on pre-order, as it's not quite out during the airing of this video, but it will be out soon, and we will see all of you at the next review.